So fougère fragrances are some of my favorite style of fragrances, and I've got a top 10 list here of fougère fragrances with three honorable mentions. We're gonna count them down, all coming right up. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian with Smelling Great Fragrance Reviews. If this is the first time you landed on this channel and or you've been watching videos here for a while, still haven't subscribed, please click the subscribe button below and also click the bell icon so you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. And as I mentioned, I'm a huge fan of fougère fragrances and I've got 10 here in the top 10 list with three honorable mentions. Last year I did several reviews for fougère fragrances, five or six of them. We'll start out with Russian Leather from Memo Paris, which is actually a leather but still with fougère aromatic notes at the top. We also reviewed the king of them all fougère fragrances. It is Fougère Royale from Houbigant, which I reviewed with Kara, one of my frequent collaborators here. We reviewed Isara from Parfum du Cita, which is actually a twist of a fougère, which is a tobacco fougère, a honeyed fougère or honeyed tobacco. Very, very unique fragrance, really lovely. We reviewed Idlewild from Indica, and also a San Francisco Bay Area indie perfumer, which is a really lovely, aromatic, refreshing fougère. Then we also reviewed Gallagher Fragrances Evergreen Dream, which is this big, beefy, hefty, traditional fougère. And then finally, Mira's Fine Fragrance, the Elysian Fields is another one we did, which is beautiful, luxury, concentrated, X-ray concentration fougère fragrance. Very, very traditional. Lovely, lovely scent. Now, speaking of Mira's Fine Fragrance, I did a video with him a few years ago about fougère fragrances, and in this video, he'll explain to you what fougère fragrances are if you don't know what they are. I'm gonna cut to that right now.
So, fougère fragrances, as Sebastian said, have been around for a very long time. The first fougère was called Fougère Royale, and it was put out by Houbigant in the late 1800s, 1882, I believe, although there's some argument about when it came out. And fougères are supposed to go and recall the smell of a fern that ferns never had. Or at least that's what Paul Parquet, the man who made Fougère Royale, described it as. He described it as the smell that he always wished that God had given ferns. And so this smell came from a combination of lavender, oak moss, and tonka bean. Although it wasn't actual real tonka bean that they used, because Fougère Royale was also the first fragrance to ever use a synthetic ingredient. In this particular case, it was coumarin, which is what makes up tonka beans.
And now that you know what fougère fragrances are, we can get started on this list. Thanks so much to Neil Peters. And a few days ago, I did a video for Elysium by Roger Parfums. It's considered a fougère, and I find it to be a very modern fougère. And that is right here, and this is honorable mention number 3, or number 1, whatever you call it, or number 13. I find this to be very classy, masculine fragrance, but very, very easy to wear, a crowd pleaser, as I was mentioning, and a compliment getter. So it's a really lovely scent. It's sophisticated, but still very easy, not stuffy, very, very easy to wear, and the perfect balance of like herbal notes at the top with the lavender at the top. But if you don't know Elysium, do check it out. I still think you can participate in the giveaway. We're doing a full bottle giveaway of it, so head over there and do that now. And that's honorable mention 1. Honorable mention number 2 is Beolea by Penhaligon's. Now this fragrance here is a unique take on fougère, a modern fougère. It's got lavender, but it also has like lots of citrus notes. It's very, very refreshing, and I find it to be very easy to wear in the summertime. So if you like a fougère style fragrance, masculine, classy, but very refreshing, this one you should definitely try. As you can see, I've use up a lot of it. It goes down easily in the summertime when it's hot and humid out, and it's really, really refreshing. So check out Beolea, and that's at number 12, or second honorable mention. And as I was mentioning earlier, the video I did for Russian Leather, this is Memo Paris. Again, very, very aromatic and fougère-like at the top, very ice cold with lots of pine tree type notes and things like that, but it warms up and it becomes a leather as it's drying down. And it, of course, it's titled appropriately Russian Leather, but it's got this unique twist of the fougère-like notes, which I really, really like. So if you like a leather fragrance with fougère-like notes, ice cold though, like really, really icy, do check it out. I really, really like this one. It's very, very underrated compared to something like African leather. So this is Russian leather from Memo Paris. So let's get started with the list. At number 10, we're going with Lavande 44. If you watched my video for Ombre Loop recently, I did for Rania J. This is another fragrance from the house that I really, really love. Smells like a traditional lavender fougere fragrance. Reminds me of the 70s for some odd reason. My dad used to wear fragrances like this. The lavender is big here. And it's very brute-like, if that makes sense. Brute, the green bottle. Lots of lavender in that one, and there's lots of lavender in here. Really, really beautiful lavender, and it's got tonka beans in the base, and traditionally, as Neil mentioned, you've got lavender in the fragrance that's considered fougere, and also tonka beans or coumarin. So here, you've got those, plus you've got some interesting other notes. There's a little bit of animalic notes in here, and then a little bit of oud in here as well, so it's a unique twist. So check it out, Lavande 44 from Rania J. That's at number 10. At number 9, we're going to the House of Chanel, and this is Boy, a Boy Chanel from Les Exclusives collection. As you can see, I've got a little bit left here, but this is a lovely, lovely scent. Very, very Chanel-like. You can pick up that Chanel DNA. It smells like a Chanel fragrance, but it's got all those aromatic and fougere notes of lavender. There's lots of geranium in here. Also, it's big with the geranium, and of course, tonka beans or coumarin in the base. It's very masculine and classy, but I find it to be unisex enough for women to wear, and I think it's considered or released as a unisex fragrance, so both sexes can wear it. And actually, I don't really have any rules. All these fragrances are unisex to me, but most people are not familiar with that, so I say this. But definitely a good one. I really like this one. I've used a lot of it, as you can see, and I think I'm due for another bottle after this is over. And if you don't know this one, do check it out. It's in the Les Exclusives collection. It's pricey, but it's really, really lovely. Get yourself a sample or decant if you want to try it out. So Boy Chanel is at number 9. Going back to the House of Penhaligon's, and this is their ultimate fougere or barbershop fragrance, and that is Sartorial right here. So this one, again, going back to that brute-like fragrance, this kind of smells like brute. But to me, this one, it does smell like Brut, but this one actually smells like even more like Brut. My dad used to wear Brut in the 70s, so I remember it very, very vividly. This one actually has a little bit of like a honey or amber in there. As you can see, the color is beautiful, amber-like, honey-like. A really, really lovely fragrance. I absolutely love it. It's classy, it's masculine, it's dressy, it's barbershop-y. It smells luxury, but it's not quite considered a luxurious fragrance, but I find it to be classy, so luxurious comes to mind. But created by Bertrand Duchaufour, one of my favorite perfumers, and who I got to meet last September. It was an awesome experience, but if you don't know it, do check it out. It's Penhaligon Sartorial at number 8. At number 7, we're going to the House of Inica, a San Francisco Bay Area perfumer, with Idlewild. I reviewed this last year, and as I was saying, it's San Francisco perfumer, of course. And Inica's got a lot of different fragrances in the collection. This is the latest, launched last year. And I find this to be a very refreshing fougere, whereas some of the other fougeres I find to be a little heavier and a little more complicated to wear on really warm days. I find this one to be very, very easy to wear, sort of like the Bayolea. But I find this one to be more of a traditional fougere compared to this, where I find it to be a unique twist on the fougere. So, a lovely scent, beautiful. It's got lots of aromatic notes, lavender, but it also has like California trees and shrubbery all mixed in, so it can smell like pine trees and things like that. Very, very lovely fragrance. If you don't know it, do check it out and check out the review. But Inica's Idlewild is at number 7. Number 6, another one that I reviewed, as I was saying earlier, and this is Parfum du Cita Isara. Now this one actually smells like a fougere, like a barbershop fougere fragrance, but it's got the glazing of honey or amber, and it's got the tobacco in there. It's a very, very masculine fragrance, but it's very soft and gentle, if that makes sense. It smells very masculine and classy, but it's got the softness and gentleness to it, where it's very unisex, if that makes sense. But the underlying barbershop and masculinity is really, really unique. So it's best of both worlds. Absolutely love this one. I love the honeyed coating on it, on the fragrance, as you can smell it. And it's very, very sexy as well. If you don't know this one, do check it out. Get yourself some samples or decants and find out all about this one. It's really, really lovely from Parfum de Cita. That's at number 6. At number 5, we're going to the House of Gallagher Fragrances, and this is the one I was mentioning I reviewed also last year, and this is Evergreen Dream. This is really hefty, big, and beefy. I think this is one of the best releases from Gallagher Fragrances, the most advanced, I think, as far as fragrances go, and I absolutely love it. And really, really love wearing it. And it's long-lasting. So if you like lavender and fougere fragrances and barbershop-y type fragrances, this is the one for you. Do check it out. Gallagher Fragrances, Evergreen Dream. Really, really lovely. Very, very classy as well. And that's at number 5. And number 4 is Mira's Fine Fragrance. And this is the Elysium Fields. So the Elysium Fields and also Elysium are derived from the same words, so I wonder what that has anything to do with fougères. But anyway, I just kind of was doing my research and I noticed that. But anyway, the Elysian Fields I reviewed as well last year, and you just saw the video with Neil Peters describing or explaining what fougères are. This is very, very sophisticated and classy fougère, very concentrated. It's X-ray concentration. Fragrances in, from Mira's Fine Fragrance go for around $65, I think, for a 15 mil. But it's X-ray, the parfum concentration, so it's the most concentrated or highly concentrated fragrance or perfume you can get. It's a 15 mil bottle, but really, really classy. To me, I find it to be like the Fougère Royale's X-ray edition in a really less expensive bottle. But again, it's not the same amount of juice. It's 15 mils compared to 100, but that is around $650 for 100 mil for the X-ray of Fougère Royale, whereas this is 15 mil. So do check it out. Mira's Fine Fragrance, I have a review of this one. We did a giveaway and we have a very, very lucky winner as well. He's been posting his pics in the group, but he really seems to like this one. So Mira's Fine Fragrance, the Elysium Fields at number 4. At number 3, we're going to the House of Amouage, and unfortunately my little thing at the top is kind of falling down. Just did it right now. I couldn't seal it back up. But this is Bracken Man. So I reviewed this a few years ago, and I find this to be a really, really beautiful. Really big on lavender. Also really big on geranium. I find lots of geranium with this one. And fougère means fern-like, as I said. And as you can see, the fern leaf is right on here. I'm sorry I have my finger on this, but as you can see, the fern leaf, that's exactly what it is. That's what a fougère is. So it's supposed to smell like a fern. So that's what they were trying to recreate when they first launched the original Fougère Royale. But Bracken Man, lovely scent. It's a really, really awesome classic style fougère, but really beefy, really long lasting. I absolutely love it. So if you don't know Bracken Man, do check it out. I highly recommend this one. Top 5 is all fougère, so you should definitely check all of them. Now, number 2, going back to an oldie but a goodie, oldie from about 15 years ago, maybe 10, 12 years ago, it is Yves Saint Laurent Rive Gauche, the men's version, and also Yves Saint Laurent Rive Gauche Intense. I have both of these. Now, recently I compared it to the latest edition of Rive Gauche in the square bottle. Very, very close. I don't have that version. I have the canisters, the classics. And lovely, lovely scent. Lots of herbal notes, aromatic notes, lavender, tonka bean in the base, of course. But it smells like a barbershop. Really, really lovely. Gorgeous, gorgeous scent. I really like the canisters because as a little kid, I grew up playing with my mom's Rive Gauche, the woman's Rive Gauche, because I love this canister. And too bad they now have it in a square bottle, but I'll get that one of these days. But I still have this, and of course, I have the intense version, which I don't find much difference with the two. But I ended up buying an intense version when it was available. This is how much I have left of the intense. Anyway, Rive Gauche, really lovely scent. If you like barbershop or fougère, definitely check it out. And that's at number 2. Finally, the last but not least, we've got Fougère Royale at number 1. I had to put it at number 1 because it's the number 1 fougère fragrance, and it's got the name Fougère Royale. This is Houbigant. They first launched this in the late 1800s, as Neil mentioned in the video that you saw. So good. So, so good. This is a later creation by Rodrigo Flores Rue, the perfumer. He redid the fragrance in 2010. So it was relaunched after, you know, sitting around for a long time, I think. But that's what I remember. But anyway, 2010 edition, really lovely barbershop like Fougere fragrance. It's classy, masculine. I think it's one of the classiest fragrances. Although I find all Fougere fragrances to be very, very classy and masculine. So if you don't know it, do try it. Do check it out and let me know what your thoughts are. Try all of these. Buy samples or decants, or of course, with Mira's Fine Fragrance, of course, you're going to have to just get the little one because it's so tiny. But anyway, guys, let me know what you think of this list. I know I left off a few I could have included on here, like At the Barbers from Maison Margiela, or even Invasion Barbare from MDCI, but there's others out there. I mean, there's lots of them. I can do a list of 50 probably, but you know, I don't have the budget for all of them. These are all in my collection. These I love and I wear all the time, and I hope you get to check them out. But if you have a favorite that I did not mention here, please put a comment down and let me know what your favorites are, or if any of these are your favorites, let me know so we can get a conversation started. And also, do you like Fougere fragrances or do you not like them? Let me know all this stuff and we'll get the conversation going. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching this video for top 10 Fougere fragrances. Please like this video, please share it. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye.